Welcome to another class of computer lessons.
So today we are going to continue this chapter. So there are some remaining portions in this chapter. So let's continue.
First one. So in our previous class we have learned about which tool? Pencil tool. Can you remember that? What is the use of a pencil tool? The pencil is used to, we know what is the use of a pencil? We can write things or type text, alphabets, letters, numbers using pencil tool. Similarly, in our paint program, we can use our pencil to draw. So pencil tool is used to draw thin lines. And how to take a pencil or how to use that pencil tool? First, go to home tab and there are some tools there. So just click the pencil tool and then select the size. Means sharpness or thickness of that pencil and also drag into that marked area, we can draw pictures, we can draw lines. Okay, so let's move to next tool, that is brush tool. So what is the next tool here? Brush tool. B R U S H. Brush. B R U S H. Brush. B R U S H. What is that? Brush tool. B O O L. Then have you seen paint brushes? The brush which is used for painting a picture. We can select some colors and then dip into the brush or take a brush and dip into different colors and then paint in a picture. That is brushes, color brushes, right? It is used for painting picture. Similarly, in our paint program, there is a brush tool. It looks like this. Brush tool. This is what? Brush tool. And this brush is used to draw thin or thick lines. We can also paint pictures, etc. So what is the use of a brush tool? Look at the picture. Brush tool is used to draw thick or thin lines. So what is the use of a brush tool? Used to draw thick, T-H-I-C-K, thick or thin lines, thick or thin lines. Once again, what is the use of a brush tool? Say, brush tool is used for draw thick. Something sharp, or we can draw thick lines, also thin lines. So brush tool is used to draw thick or thin lines. Then here, look at the picture. We can draw thin lines and thick lines. Means we can draw here letter A using thin lines. So here, these lines are very thin and we can also draw thick lines. Thick lines, right? So, brush tool is used to draw thick or thin lines. Thick or thin lines. This is thin line and this is an example of thick line. Brush tool, B-R-U-S-H, brush tool, T-O-O-L, tool, is used to draw thin lines and thick lines. Thin lines or thick lines, right? Okay, then next, how to use this brush tool? There are some steps for using brush tool. So let's see what are the steps. First one, click home tab. So what is the first step? Click home tab. We know there are two tabs. What are they? Home tab and view tab. So first click home tab and then click which tool? Which tool?
to draw. Here this is paint brush and drag the mouse pointer to draw the picture of lecture. So then drag. So what are the steps? First step, click home tab, then click brush tool, then click or select the size of the brush. Size of the brush for thin lines or thick lines. If you want thick line, just select the thick size, means large size. And if you want thin line, just select it first size, means it is the lower size in the size button. And then drag that brush, that means drag the pointer to draw the lines of picture. Right? So here, we have to learn an important tool, that is brush tool. What is the spelling of brush? B-R-U-S-H. Okay. Then also one more thing. You can also select the color from color box. Color from color box or color blue. First you mount table, brush tool, then select the size and color. Drag the pointer. So finally, what happens? Look at the picture. You can draw different size lines using this brush tool. That means here, look at A, first picture, very thin line, and then something more than the first one, thick lines of A. Then here, you can see a very big thick lines, etc. So a brush tool is used to draw thick or thin lines. Next one is eraser tool. So next tool is what? Eraser tool.
Unwanted options. U S E D is there. T of two. E R A S E erase. Q A W A N T unwanted. P O R T I O N S portions. Unwanted portions of a picture or of the drawing. Then, so here look at the picture. There is a bird. So here,
color tool is used to fill color in the shapes you draw. draw. Fill color in the shades you draw. So what is the use of a fill with color tool? Fill with color tool is used to fill the color into the shapes you draw.
Fill the color into the shapes you draw. So here F-I-L-L fill, T-H-E-G, C-O-L-O-R color, I-N-T-O into, T-H-E-D, S-H-A-P-E-S shapes, Y-O-U-U, D-R-A-W draw, fill the color in the shapes you draw.
Then, next is how to fill with color tool. To fill the colors, first click home tab, then second one, then select fill with color tool and then click the color you wanted to fill the shape. So select color 1 and color 2 and then click on that shape. So look at the picture. First, go to home tab. So this is the home tab. Under the home tab, there are some tools. And just select the paint bucket, or which is also known as fill with the color tool. And then go to the color group. Then select suitable color. So for example, here we select a color that is red. So, color 1 contains red. And then, next, after that, click on the closed shape. For example, it's big red color. Fill that red into this shape. So, once again, how to use fill with color tool? First one, go to home tab and then click the tool fill with color and then select the colors from the color group and then click on the closed shape. So that what happens finally, that color will filled into that shape. Next is leaking of color. Leaking of color means, do you know why sometimes colors leak? Take a look here. This is a shape of a circle, but there are some broken line here. This is not a closed surface or closed shape. There is some broken line. So, in this case, if you want to paint to that surface or that space, that closed shape, what happens? The color leaks. The color leaks out because the shape is not closed. If the shape is closed, the color filled in that closed area. But if there is a broken line in the shape, you cannot fill the color into that particular shape. Sorry, but also fill with their background. So here some edges are left open so that the color will leak out and background will also fill with the colors. So, then what is the solution? Just complete the circle. Complete the circle means joining the line. After that, we can put or fill the color in that closed surface. So, before filling the color, check your drawing is close the open. Then next is drawing ready made shapes. Drawing ready made shapes. In our tools or toolbox, there is a tool named different ready made shapes. Ready made shape means we do not need to create a rectangle or a triangle or a circle, but instead of that, there are also some ready made shapes. So let's see what is that. Once again, click on the Home tab. Second one, click a ready-made shape. Select a color for the outline. Outline means if you construct a rectangle shape, you select a red color so that the outline becomes red in color. Then select a color, drag the drawing area to draw the shape. Then next is polygon 2. So finally, another tool named is polygon 2.
Polygon 2, POLYGON 2, POLYGON 2. 2, 4 is that? So, once again, P O L R L Y G O A, polygon. Polygon tool is used to draw shapes with any number of sides. So, what is the use of a polygon tool? It is used to draw shapes with the any number of sides. Use it to USED, use the TO to draw, DRAW, draw shapes, SHAPES shapes with the WITH, with the any ANYE, NUMBER number of all sides, SIDES sides. So, using to draw shapes with the any number of sides. Once again, what is a polygon tool? Polygon tool is used to draw shapes with any number of sides. Then, how to open a polygon tool? First, click on the home tab, then select the polygon tool. Polygon tool, it's look like this. Here is the polygon tool. Polygon tool. So we can construct any shape with any number of sides. So here look at the picture. Click on the home tab. Click the polygon tool. Then to draw a polygon, drag the pointer to draw a straight line. First, just draw the line using mouse pointer by dragging. So dragging the mouse pointer to construct a line. Then after that, then after clicking at the position here, then again drag the mouse pointer to the top portion. Then click there. Then after that, click the left or right. Then you can construct a different any shape. You can construct any shape with any number of sides. That is the polygon tool. So what is the use of a polygon tool? It is used to construct any shape with any number of sides. So here, let's go to a quick practice. Draw the following using the tools learned in this chapter. So here, this is the shape of an ice cream. So the question, draw the following tools, using the tools learned this chapter. So, what are the shapes in this ice cream? It contains a triangle shape and there are some cross lines. Then there are some circles, also some outline shape. So, how to write or how to draw this picture? First step, we know what are the tools we have to use in this picture. We can select a color tool, then pencil tool, brush tool, shapes, ready-made shapes, etc. First, construct a shape of triangle. Yes. So, how to construct a shape? Using a brush tool. Using brush tool, we can construct this triangle. And we can also draw lines using pencil tool. Then next step, after that we have to construct the three circles. So go to ready-made shapes and then select three circles and drag it into the top of the triangle. Then next step, using the brush, you can draw the outline of this shape. Then after that, just click the brush and then draw a circle and then fill with a color. And then draw another shape. So that means we can construct any shape using ready-made shapes. We can construct triangle,
we can construct serpent. Then A shapes using ready-made shapes. Then you can also draw the picture of house using these shapes. So look at the picture, page number 45. Here there is a picture of a house. So you can construct this house using the shapes. So what are the shapes inside this house? There is a triangle shape, there is a rectangle, then there are some stars, then also a pentagon. So here first draw a rectangle, and on the top of that just construct a triangle, and then add two stars into the triangle area, and then draw a pentagon. So here pentagon means which contains five sides. Then after that, after drawing all the shapes, then fill color into the shape using fill with color too. Then so let's go to the worksheet number 1. A bee and an ant and a bird are sitting on the picture of a green screen. Write down the names of the parts of the screen where they are sitting. So look at the worksheet number 1. There is a bird, an ant, and also a bee. So you have to find out the names of the parts of the screen where the bird, bee, and an ant sitting. So first look at the bird. What is that part? What is its name? So that part is home tower. So question number 8. The ant is sitting on the nut. Ant is sitting on the where? So look at the picture. Ant is sitting on the which stool? Filled with the color too. So you have to write ant sitting on the filled with the color too. So just write the blank line filled with the color too. Then second question. The bee is sitting on the. Bee is sitting on the where? On the working area or drawing area. So you have to write the blank line. What? The bee is sitting on the drawing area. And the third one, the bird is sitting on the where? Bird is sitting on the home tab. So you have to write the bird is sitting on the home tab. So just do the worksheet number 1. And then let's move to second worksheet. So here, help Tiny to draw lines to match the real life objects given below with the paint tools which perform the same function in paint. So on the left side we can see there are some tools. Look there, and what are the tools present in the left side? First one, a brush tool, then a pencil, a rubber, and a fill with color or bucket, paint bucket. Then on the right side there are some paint and brushes, a pencil, and a rubber. Then the question is, you have to match the brush with the real life brush. That means here first one matches to second of the right side. So first here our tool, brush tool, and then it matches to the real life brush, the second picture on the right side. Then next, second one, pencil tool. So you have to match pencil tool with the real life pencil. So real life pencil is on the third picture of the right side. So pencil tool with the real life pencil. Then next, third one, eraser tool. So eraser tool matches to the eraser. And fourth one, fill with color tool matches to paint bucket or paint packet in real life. So that is the worksheet number 2. We have to match each of these in paint tools and the real life objects. Then go to worksheet number 3. Rearrange and correct the name of the tools in the empty spaces below. So here there are some words, but it is not in the correct order. So you have to rearrange the words and make the correct word. So let's see the first one, HRBUS. So can you identify which is that word? It is, we already learned that word. What is that word? Brush. Then what is the spelling of brush? B-R-U-S-H. So just write the blank line. Brush. B-R-U-S-H. Okay. Then second one. G-O-N-Y-P-O-L. Then can you identify which is that word? Starting with letter P. Polygon. P-O-L-Y-G-O-N. Polygon. P-O-L-Y-G-O-N. Then third one. R-S-R-E-A-E. So it's look like a rubber. Means eraser. That means the tool that is eraser tool. So you have to write eraser. What is the spelling of eraser? E-R-A-S-E-R. Then fourth one, the picture looks like a pencil. So we know that is pencil tool. So what is the spelling of the pencil? P-E-N-C-I-L. Then let's go to worksheet number 4. Help Manoj to match the following tools with their functions by drawing lines. So there are some tools given in that picture. Then you have to match with their uses. First one, what is that picture? It is the picture of a brush tool. So what is the use of a brush tool? Drawing thin lines. Drawing thin lines. Then next one. The second one is the picture of an eraser tool. So what is the use of an eraser tool? The first sentence, erasing lines. Erasing lines. So second one matches to the first sentence, erasing lines. Then third one, right side, fill with color tool. So it matches to filling colors. So second sentence, filling colors. And fourth one, it's a pencil tool, drawing straight lines. So you have to match each of the tool with their uses. Then worksheet number 5, write the name of the tools and the balloons attached with them. So there are 4 balloons in this picture. You have to match these balloons with each of the tools. So first balloon joined with the first, which is that tool? Eraser tool. So write here, eraser. So inside the balloon, you have to write the word eraser. Second one, then the second balloon joined with the letter A, which is that tool? Text tool. So you have to write the word text tool in the second balloon. And third balloon, which joined to the brushes. So you have to write the word brush tool inside the third balloon. And the fourth one, which joined to the another tool, what is that tool? Polygon tool. So you have to write the word polygon on the fourth balloon. So these are the 5 worksheets. So our chapter 6 ends here. So all of you study well, and we will continue with another chapter later. Thank you.